Hello! Welcome to Tango at home. How are you?
How are you, everyone?
We hope that you are fine.
Yes.
We want to say thank you for all of you that were participating in our live class on Saturday. It's really nice to see all your faces. We feel that we are giving the class with you. It's really, really nice.
You're working, you are sweating, you're asking. It's really inspiring for us. We really want to do it again next Saturday.
But next Saturday we will change the time. We will start at 5:30. That's for you to have a little bit longer sunny day now when the days start to get longer.
But now we have this class.
Yes, and today we're going to work as a follower. We're going to work a back saccada, and we will also do one very nice embellishment.
And for the leaders, we will show you some tips for you when you have to do the lead for the back saccada, or what do you have to do in the moments when you do an embellishment. So we will see it right now. Let's check it out.
So leaders, we will start with a side step. After that, we will change our weight. In this moment, we are going to lead a back ocho for her to go into saccada while we are going forward. Here. Now she will continue into the half turn while I'm doing a pivot. I will enter into the saccada here. Then I will continue to do an extra saccada with my right, change my weight forward, back with the right, and here you will wait supporting with embrace her embellishment. We will emphasize the timing here, pam, to then go forward with the left, forward with the right, and here we will lead a freno.
As a follower, I'm starting with a side step to the right. I do one back ocho, and now I'm doing the back saccada with my right leg. I continue into a turn side forward while the leader is doing a saccada. I continue with one more side step while the leader is doing the saccada. And now I enter into my back step where I will do my embellishment. I end in the back cross without changing the weight. And I go out in cross system with my left leg back, ending in a freno.
Leaders, to lead the back saccada, we need to focus in one moment, is when we have the weight in both legs. So I will show you where. One, two, three. Here, while we are transferring our weight to the left, we need to create a traction with the shoulder blade, with the dorsals. To lead a tiny pivot on her standing leg. So, traction, here. Now, we are ready to go forward with the right, and she has a space to go into the back saccada. This is the first moment of the leading. The second moment of the lead is after she's doing the saccada, what we are going to do there. So we have this one, two, three, four saccada here. Here, I will focus on my right shoulder, that this will be my fixed point. I will not move that point, but I will let and allow my lower body to go into the pivot. So you can see it. Now, now by keeping this shoulder in the same spot and letting my lower body pivot, I can reach the saccada without any problem. Okay, now I can transfer my weight in both legs to then go into the next saccada here. That was the second tip. The last tip leader is in the moments when she's doing the embellishment. We will give her the time to create, to be creative with her timing, what she's listening on the music. So in which moment is this happening? So we have 1, 2, 3, sacada, 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 here. Here I can feel that Sarah is telling me that she wanna do an embellishment. Okay, what I have to do as a leader? I will create an expansion on my back, which will go through my center until my embrace to give a firm support for her. So then she will feel safe in this spot and she can create anything that she wants. Of course, while she's doing this, I'm listening of the music and also I'm paying attention when she wants to end this embellishment. So then when she's ending, we focus on the beat, pim, we go 1, 2, freno.
For the embellishment, so when I'm starting the embellishment, I'm going into a back step. Here it's really important that I anchor my right hip over my heel before I even can start to move my free leg. I will show you in this way. So I'm pushing the hip down to that heel, and after that is pushing down, I can start to lift my leg up. Be careful that the hip is not going outside of the heel line or that it's in front of the heel line. So I need to go over and down to lift my leg up. So as an exercise, you can just take here, you can press it down and feel how the leg is lifting up at the same time. Be careful with this, that everything is going up. Down to go up. Now, what I'm doing with my free leg, after I arrived over my right leg, I'm going to turn out my front leg and I'm going to lift it up. Then I'm going to bend the foot to me. I'm going to turn the whole leg inside together with my left hip. I'm going to lower that leg to the ground. The knees will be together and the foot in the floor. I will push it forward and I will create a small pivot in my standing leg when I'm pushing it forward. I will turn it out together with my whole hip, so the leg will go out in the other way. Then I will continue into a half circle behind me. I will cross behind me without changing my weight. And then I'm going to go back together with my leader. I will show you one more time. Lift, bend, turn in, go down, push forward, push out, around, cross. Go. Technical details for the back sacada for the follower. After I arrived in my back leg, it's important that I turn my free leg inside in this way. Then I push my foot behind me and then I push my leg behind my standing leg. And after that, I create a pivot. I will show you in this way. So we have 1, 2, 3. Now I can create a pivot. And I will use that motion in the free leg that is moving to me and behind me. That weight will help me to create the force to go around. 1, 1. That is very different than if I start from the upper part by turning the upper part and then it's coming the lower part. One exercise for the back sacada for the follower. So we'll go into a side step and then into the back ocho. And in the same direction I'm stepping with my left leg, I will do the pivot and I will step in the same direction with the right leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Thank you for watching the video. We really appreciate that you're sharing the time with us. If you have any question, please write on the comment below. We will answer you. Or if you prefer to send a private message, we will answer you as well. Don't forget to practice the exercise that we're giving to you, okay?
Also remember that the live class on Saturday is changed time. So it's 5:30 for followers and 6:15 for leaders.
At 4 p.m. on Sunday, we have the Tango Fika Cafe. So join us with Panos and Rita. We're going to have a really, really, really fun. We're waiting for you.
Before that, though, on Thursday, Rita and Panos will have a new class out about this sequence, so practice the steps, but they will work the musicality.
Subscribe to the channel. Give a like, please.
Thank you, as always, for the support. It's really nice, always. And have a beautiful week. Ciao! Subscribe to our channel here and like the video. Thank you for your support. Thank you.